Hello everyone, welcome back to Z Physics. Today we're going to be talking about Hubble's law. Now, in order to discuss Hubble's law, we have the following graph over here. We have the velocity in kilometers per second, and we have the distance in megaparsecs. What Edwin Hubble did in the 1920s was devote his whole life to figuring out the speeds and the relative distances to distant galaxies. He did some amazing work in documenting and developing experimental techniques to observe and calculate the velocity of distant galaxies and their distance. He produced a plot of the velocity against the distance, and lo and behold, we can see that there is a linear relationship between those quantities. Mathematically, we can write that the velocity of a distant galaxy, v, is proportional to the distance from the distant galaxy to the Earth, and that constant of proportionality is known as Hubble's constant, which is normally given the symbol H0. This is in fact Hubble's law. The recession speed of a galaxy is directly proportional to its distance from the Earth. Notice that if this comes up in an exam question, we need to make sure that we use the word galaxy, because Hubble's law applies to distant galaxies and clusters of galaxies rather than to nearby object. It is a fantastic law, and if you think about it, it tells us that everything is moving away from everything else, and the further away something is, the faster it is actually moving away. We can apply y equals mx plus c analysis, and if we do that, so let's just write down underneath y is equal to mx plus c. We can see that our intercept is equal to 0. We have d on the x-axis, we have v on the y-axis, and we can see that our gradient is equal to Hubble's constant. So in a v against d graph, our gradient is equal to Hubble's constant. This time over here is actually a very, very special time, and this is in fact the age of the universe. If we extrapolate backwards in time, and because currently all of these galaxies are running away from each other, that means that a second ago they were a little bit closer, another second ago they were even closer still. If we extrapolate backwards all the way to the beginning of the universe, we can see that the universe will have a finite age at which all of the galaxies, all of the space-time has collapsed to a singularity. This actually introduced the idea of the Big Bang. So in this equation, that H0 is equal to 1 over time, this time over here is actually the age of the universe. The units of H0, because of that, are seconds to the power of minus 1. Well, these are the SI units. According to the graph, they're also in non-standard units. There will be kilometers per second per megaparsecs. Now join us in the next video, in which we're going to convert Hubble's constant to SI units, and we're going to calculate the age of the universe. Thank you very much for watching.